Hi, I'm Matt Rowan. I work with Jason Christie. He's a group leader at Max Planck Florida Institute for Neuroscience. We look at the physiology of neurons, so basically how neurons actually work and how they behave. I study a part of a neuron called the axon, and the axon is a cable that's attached to these neurons that actually sends signals from one neuron to the next. So what I like about being able to work in the lab is, of course, the discovery feature of science is first and foremost, but also the freedom you get when you're working in an academic style lab like we do. I was born in New York, and I grew up there from a very young stage. I knew I wanted to do science. I knew I liked biology from a really young age as well. I'm not exactly sure why, it just kind of was something that resonated with me as a kid. And it wasn't until maybe the university level that I'd start to become more interested in the more specific neuroscience field. I got into research primarily because that's all I really wanted to do. So it was pretty easy to get into it because when you're an undergraduate or a graduate student, the people who are in charge of the lab, the heads of labs, they always want more help. So if you can provide them with some work at those levels, then usually that's a great way to get involved. So the harder parts are actually if you're writing a grant, you know, you have to figure out how to do that. Or if you're writing a paper, you have to learn the style. If you want to get published, you have to realize that you have to go through a review process, and all these things take a lot of time and effort. The things that we're interested in has been not extensively examined because of technical limitations up until this point. So that's been one of the nice things about being at Max Planck in Florida, is that we've had great resources and been able to sort of spend time developing some new and difficult techniques in order to get after some interesting questions regarding these presynaptic specializations and how they work. So in order to do that, we have to give certain frequency pulses, depolarizations. Mm-hmm. What do you think?
Well, I think it's good. So we are going 100 hertz for all the trials.
Yeah, 100 hertz. What fascinates me about my project is my hope that we have the ability to sort of look into things that others have not in great depth. I definitely hope that the things that we're doing here are going to generate novel ideas in terms of how we can look into neurodegenerative diseases and other disease states. The advice I would give to a high school level student that's looking to do research as a career is attempt to do some research right now. Hopefully you've tried some things and worked in a lab setting already quite a bit. I mean, there's plenty of opportunities for younger people to do this if you're in the right places. So that's the advice I would give.